It's the end of an era in Germany as the country's Social Democrats narrowly defeated Angela Merkel's party, ending 16 years of conservative rule. Here's the full story.
Germany's Social Democrats narrowly won a milestone election on Sunday, a victory that marks an end to 16 years of conservative rule under Angela Merkel. Projected results showed the center-left Social Democrats were on track for 26% of the vote, ahead of nearly 25% for the conservative bloc, though both groups believe they could lead the next government. SPD's candidate for Chancellor, Olaf Scholz, thanked his supporters.
And of course, I'm very happy about the election result that the citizens of this country have chosen. They have decided that the SPD should rise upwards, and that is a big success.
Scholz would become the fourth socialist Democrat chancellor since World War II. His conservative rival, Armin Laschet, signaled his bloc was not ready to concede, though his supporters were more subdued.
We will do everything possible to build a conservative-led government because Germany
Deutschland.
Germany now needs a future coalition that modernizes our country.
The most likely outcome is a three-way alliance involving the smaller Greens and liberal Free Democrats, led by either the Social Democrats or Merkel's conservatives. A new coalition could take months, and Merkel will remain in charge in a caretaker role while Scholz and Laschet court the support of the smaller parties. They have both said they aim to form a coalition before Christmas.
Kabul's airport now fully operational for international flights. That's according to the Taliban's Ministry of Foreign Affairs, which said all airlines can now resume operations. The ministry also assures the public of full cooperation in conducting flights. Flights were suspended at the airport following the Taliban's takeover in mid-August, with the exception of evacuation flights. The UK suspends competition laws to allow oil companies to target fuel deliveries. The move would make it easier for suppliers to share information and prioritize parts of the country most at need. Oil firms said a lack of drivers was causing transport problems from refineries to gas stations. BP earlier said nearly a third of its fuel stations in the UK are running dry. This follows days of long lines at gas stations after fuel shortages sparked panic buying.
So the most important thing is actually that if people carry on as they normally would and fill up their cars when they normally would, then you won't have queues and you won't have shortages at the pump either.
The leader of the British opposition, meanwhile, blames the UK government for the fuel shortages.
This is a complete lack of planning. No, we exited the EU. One consequence was there was going to be a shortage of HGV drivers. That was predictable. It was predicted. So I say to the Prime Minister, we need a concrete plan today to deal with this problem, because otherwise this is going to go on till Christmas.